Hey guys, welcome back to D20 House, where a bunch of nerds get together, roll dice, and slay monsters. Tonight it is Friday night, which means we are continuing our playtest of For the Good of All, a Call of Duty Zombies-inspired tactical war game. Guys, I'm excited to be here. I hope all of you are excited. Tonight we've got T. James, who we haven't seen in a hot minute. Good to have you, buddy. Odie, Ian,
hey.
Forever a Slave, and myself, Taffa, and we're going to have a great time. Ian, any announcements?
Christ, we're back. We're all here. My Hero's gonna happen Monday, finally.
Thank God.
It's been 3 weeks. Wednesday. Man. We're back to the full schedule, lads.
Winter season.
We're looking at wrapping this up here relatively soon. Mm-hmm. The next thing should be Wyatt's Attack on Titan short campaign.
Yeah. Nice. And then a little bit of
And then we're going back to Modern Warfare.
And then eventually
the
back
sequel
to
Madison Square Mayhem. And then eventually, yeah, we'll do a little more playing of this. And we'll figure it out from there.
Yeah.
Got some other people working on some other things.
Okay.
We'll figure it out.
It's our revolving door night. But tonight we're getting into it. No Colby this week. He will be back. But for now, James, I'm glad to have you.
Yes. Pleasure to be here.
So, who remembers where we left off, you three?
Not me.
Not you. You were gone. Who remembers where we left off?
It's what? Second generator? Third generator?
We just finished generator two.
Generator two. Yeah.
And we did generator three out of order.
Well, yeah.
But the order doesn't
matter. Third generator in totality.
Mm-hmm. 3 out of 6. We're halfway there.
Living on a prayer.
I'm a bomb.
If you guys head out into no man's land, things are going to get a little intense. You won't be hiding in the trenches anymore, and so you'll be exposed to the elements, to the battlefield, and to the eyes of the ravenous dead. But for now, I know we were talking about maybe doubling back and checking out the last section of trench that we haven't seen yet. Is that still the plan?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. The entire area from generator 1, 2, and 3 is all kind of a big loop that circles through the operations bunker. You guys have gone through the generator 3 section of the loop, now hit generator 2, and there are still two more paths you guys could go look down. So,
straight to hell, or...
There's the fire tunnel, and then there's... What else? What was the other one?
Well, there's... there was like an electromagnetic door sealing off the area between generator 2 and generator 1.
Right.
Also, on the other side, like the Gen 2 arena you guys fought in, there was that bunker. There was a back door to the bunker that we didn't explore.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't like actually physically a door, just a little stairwell up into something.
Yeah.
And yeah. Still some more exploring we could do,
yeah.
Or
we gotta find three more generators, or is it clear that the generators are not in this area?
They're not in this
okay.
area.
All right. So we're at max.
We have to head to
objectives.
The main dig site.
Yeah. Okay.
Lovely, more exploration.
Well, I don't want to go in the fire tunnel because those motherfuckers explode, and I do
there
melee
are flaming
damage.
Zombies.
What's not love?
They throw fireballs at you.
We're right next to the bunker. If there's something on top of the bunker, we probably ought to just check that first.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Yeah. So like the bunker above Gen 2. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the closest.
The one where the
like...
giant was stepping.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cool. You guys head up there and someone roll a perception check.
That's me.
You can get aid from an ally for free. So
I'll
don't
take
forget
aid
that.
From one of you.
I'll help you.
That's
an extra D6 for aid.
Is. Oh, yeah, that's right. An extra D6. Woo.
Holy Ooh. Shit.
What's that then? 19 on the die plus 11, 30 total.
Wow.
11?
Yeah, I got a passive 5, and then I put 6 skill points in.
So. Awesome.
Keep in mind, the maximum DC is 40 for any roll. So 11's pretty crazy.
Close.
But you also just rolled incredibly.
I did roll very well there. My D6 is coming through to me tonight. I can feel it.
Takeo Masaki, you head up to the top of the bunker, kind of crawling up the piles of rubble that have broken down from the roof. This shouldn't really be like a second floor, you know? It's only that way because it, like, these false stairwells have fallen down, allowing access.
It's compressed.
You get up there, and there are a couple corpses that have been very firmly mulched by the giant's foot. You see one of them, just as before, in that tunnel near Generator 3, one of the corpses is wrapped around a piece of like
we got a staff kiblet,
some kind of like mechanical implement.
Dibsies.
When you peel the corpse's arms off of it and examine it, it doesn't look like one like a rod, like the staff part did.
Oh, okay.
It looks more like the zombie shield part that you had found before.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that little, like, bunker shed near the fire tunnel. You guys found one sitting in a wheelbarrow.
Yeah.
We've collected 2/3 of the zombie shield. Keep an eye out for that third part. It could be a useful tool.
Sweet.
And as you're surveying the area from the top of this... I need the Muppet dice. As you're
Muppet
surveying
bucket.
The area...
They've been squished to jelly, it seems.
The giant robot doesn't patrol. But you also see... The generator you just fought for was, like, directly below you into your east.
Uh-huh.
And you're on the bunker building right next to it. You're, like, looking down over the generator.
Yeah.
But when you look west... On the other side of the bunker, you see kind of an open field with what looks like tank tracks. And you realize, oh, like that is a tank path that might lead all the way through the middle of like the main camp of the dig site. And on the other side, there are some trenches and a fourth giant robot.
No man.
Three are patrolling the entire camp, but a fourth has crashed in the middle or just like out in the field. Past this tank area.
He's it big is McChillin.
Actively on fire. Oh. There's like flame pouring out of the shattered glass of its monocular visor. But you could go explore it, you think, if you wanted to.
Or do I want to? We'll decide that maybe a little later.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there's a shield fragment up there.
Got it.
Nothing else.
Yep.
Besides, of course, the related information. So, Magnetic door?
Magnetic door.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Just to clarify, if you choose to go that way, the fourth giant robot is an explored... Is a wreckage you can explore.
Is an explorable zone.
As a team, yeah.
Okay. We just gotta hit... It's like a side objective.
Yes, it is a side objective.
Yeah!
I love side quests. Mm-hmm.
Throw all the best loot.
We'll kind of look around the rest of the tutorial zone. Maybe we'll bail out to that first.
We double back to the magnetic door. Richtofen, you swipe your card through it, and it opens up with a hiss of steam. We're going to roll D6 for an outbreak.
One.
No outbreak. You guys can head through this trench unbothered by the dead.
I'm always unbothered by the dead.
Bother.
If we want to examine this area for more stuff, insight or perception check, and we'll get to it. That'll be 3 dice.
You don't want to roll perception. You want me to roll perception.
Yeah, he's really good at perception.
Because I've got a passive 11. A little help from my friends. Okay. Oh, 11, 13, 14, 25.
25. This trench is kind of a diagonal... section that leads back to that first bunker where the first generator was. In fact, Takeo, you jumped down into this trench to enter that bunker when you first came searching for the doctor. But what you had failed to notice before stream and all that, you know, there is kind of like an underground section of bunker here that cuts through the middle of this trench area as well. If we get into a combat here, like, I'll draw it out for you. There are a couple noteworthy things. You see a chalk outline that kind of glows like the other weapons that you've seen in the area over kind of an empty ammo box. It looks like a shotgun, probably.
If you
come here, you could use divinium to manifest a shotgun or ammunition for a shotgun from the ether. But also in the kind of underground bunker section, there is some equipment.
Ooh.
And there's another shovel.
Another shovel. Well, we've already got one.
Well, okay.
I don't need another.
In terms of equipment, there is what looks like some kind of landmine, but you don't recognize its make.
Okay. I mean, I've already got landmines.
Yep. Does anyone else want some lethal equipment?
How much would it be XP-wise to get more ammo?
To get more ammo for your shotgun, 650 experience.
And that fills you up, or?
It's going to give you 3 magazines worth of ammo.
So what for that? 21 shells?
I think for him it'll be...
7 plus 1, 8?
I think it's six shells 16. He's got per... Shotgun, so I think it'll be 18.
Okay.
Yeah.
Shotgun ammo comes in magazines.
No. It's the tube.
Got it.
Yeah.
So it'd be like it'd be like a 6+1 or a 7+1.
Yeah.
Or like they got those new tactical self-defense shotguns where they're double tubes, so it's 14+1.
No, this is like an old school. This is a trench gun from
old school. I think that's seven. I think those are 7+1s.
Yeah. The rules don't account for a specific make and model of guns.
Right. Mine don't either. I just averaged standard today.
There's a little bit of volley fire in there, you know.
Obviously the double barrel doesn't get gets its own special ammunition category, but every other tube shotgun
7+650, yeah. And that'll give you 18 ammo. Okay. So there's a box for all of your ammunition, and you can add 18 to the medium shotgun section. Cool. And keep track of you
spending
total
spend
spent
that for the
experience.
Party too. The party's 30,000 goal.
Yeah. And if it put you over 3K spent, you level up as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it heads back under.
No. Because you have available experience, and then below that is total spent experience.
Mm-hmm.
So when you spend 650, it goes from the total available experience to the total spent experience.
Yep.
Right now I have enough to do that.
Oh, damn. How much do you have available?
100.
Oh, no. You do not have enough.
Unfortunate. Never Sorry. Mind. Total spend is just there so we can track like what your level is, basically. But available is what's in your wallet.
Capital One.
Yeah, there's another magnetic door on the other side of this, and that leads back to Generator 1. If we want, we could go explore the original bunker again. Maybe if anyone wants to get, like, Quick Revive or get ammo for a rifle.
What did Quick Revive cost?
1,500.
1,500? We need one more combat encounter, because I would like Quick Revive.
Mm-hmm. I almost have enough. Well, you could run around and hope for an outbreak.
Yeah, that's kind of what I've been trying to do here.
Well, let's continue that.
If we go to bunker one, right off of that is the fire tunnel, so we could go bunker one, hope for an outbreak, and then to the trench and go to the fire tunnel and hope for an outbreak. And at any point if we get it, we'll double back.
Okay. Yeah, you guys head into the generator one bunker. Here's how outbreaks work, because we've only traveled through empty zones once before. Every time you travel through an empty zone and don't get an outbreak, the next time you do it, you get roll an extra die.
We rolled a 6. On sixes. All right.
Yep, we're waiting on 6.
Noise. Got it. Sweet, we get to have a fight in bunker one. I need like 3 kills. And if anybody else wants Quick Revive, you should.
Because
Quick Revive's great.
Or 2 kills.
Two and a quarter.
Two and a quarter.
I'm 2.5 away. But unless there's a good trench zombie and somebody else is below half hit points to give me my bonus damage, I'm killing normal zombies.
I thought we had 2 other people.
I am 1 hit point off from being half or below. James, I think you're currently at like half hit points. Does Colby have a hit point counter going on?
26.
Out of
62.
Oh,
okay,
man.
So you're below half. I can 100% benefit from you. Do you got a hit point counter going?
Looks like I'm at 31 out of 42.
Out of 42? Damn. Close.
All right. You guys, I'm going to give me your minis. I'll take the 4 of them. Yeah. Exciting. Who's first in line?
I'm running around like a violent psychopath. Yeah.
Cool. I'll probably follow behind.
What's new?
I'll gladly be as much in the middle as possible.
Okay. Put baby in the middle.
Yeah.
Stay away from windows. This is a zone where they don't fall from like the roof or anything, right?
They fall from the roof in here.
Okay.
In the other room, yeah. Otherwise, you guys remember there's an entrance over here. You opened this door. You opened these doors. So there's 2 more entrances.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
There's like 4 over here.
There's a window.
One here, and one here. So there are like 7 entrances into this room now.
I'll take the doorway and the window on like that furthest from me side. James, if you want to take the little stairwell that goes down to that open area, okay. If you want to stand right next to Quick Revive.
I want to stand right next
and then you
to
guys
the
can
machine.
Guard that other door.
Okay. The other side. There we go.
Just put me right in front of that open space. Because okay. we don't have to stand in the generator area.
Okay, you want to be like right here?
No. Well, yeah, actually, that's fine because then I can swing at everybody.
Mm-hmm. You guys come sprinting into the room and you hear the screeching of the damned nearby. All right, someone coin toss. You guys are high, enemies are low. Someone roll a die.
Roll, James. High as always.
Low.
Shit, okay. Enemies start flooding the area.
You should have overruled me before you threw the die.
Here we go.
Also remember your toughness procs when you're half or below or whatever. Yeah. So every round after your turn, make sure that gain those two hit points and do the things.
All right. Enemies begin to flood the area.
I thought they were zombies.
Hmm? Yeah. Okay.
I thought they were people zombies.
Flood.
Zombies. Ooh, zombie. You guys have an objective. I think, you know, Takeo, Nikolai, you should be able to see it. So I will show you. Over in the other room.
A trench zombie.
A trench zombie comes crawling out of this window. But Nikolai, I think you have the best view of it. Roll perception check for me. That's 3d6 plus your perception bonus and your skills. Holy shit.
Nice.
Pretty good roll. Fourteen.
There's 13 on the die. What's your bonus?
You should add your valor. And
passive six.
Okay, never mind.
30 plus 6, 19.
Oh yeah, Colby built valor. Oof. 19. You see this trench zombie, it is like, you know, it has the breastplate, it's wrapped in barbed wire, it's dripping with mud. Pretty standard fare. But something about it seems off because its eyes are not the kind of glowing yellow that you've been seeing from all of the dead. They are a deep purple, and some kind of like etheric purple flame is roiling off of its head and shoulders as it comes crawling through this window and into the arena.
We have an abnormal.
It's evolving.
He's got a knife.
All right.
It's Abby normal.
The like objective purple. For this battle, this is a showdown. You guys have a specific enemy you need to eliminate, and the rest of the enemies will not die or will not stop spawning until you do.
Boy, I wonder who the specific enemy we have to defeat is.
Boy, I wonder.
I can't see.
So, enemies first. Takeo, you're lucky. They kind of pile up in this door.
That's gonna suck. Takeo wanted Dempsey or Nikolai. God damn it.
All right. Takeo, you're going to take 3 points of damage. Nikolai, you also take 3 points of damage. And Richtofen, you take 5 points of damage as the dead come running into the room and start mauling us.
Well, how'd one get to the doctor instead of to...
One came through this window.
Oh, there's a window there?
I didn't know there was a window there. Yeah.
Yeah, there was one last time we fought in this room.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know.
Yeah. Sorry.
On the bright side, that puts me below half hit points.
Oh, hooray! Well, that's -4 for damage. So does that mean I take damage? Because he got hit first.
He did get hit first. So your damage reduction completely reduces the hit.
And you have taken no damage.
Yeah! Shell shock for the win. Let's go. All right. For the audience, anyone who can watch, Shellshock gives Odie's character stacking damage reduction per player who's below half health, which gets fun. Max is out at 8. All right, that's all the enemies for now. Back to y'all. Who's going first?
Let me clear out these two adds in front of you, and then you can shotgun that special guy in the face.
If you shotgun someone within two spaces, you deal an extra die of damage.
Which you are in two spaces of.
Actually, you're diagonal them, so you need to move. That'd be 3 spaces. Oh, wait, no. From corner. My bad. You're good. I'm dumb.
Yeah. Let me clear some ads here. First guy's dead.
Absolutely.
Second guy's dead.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. 200 XP. You get some honor. Good man. James.
You need to step up in front of me at least.
You tank for him.
Yeah.
You gotta tank for him. Doctor, you're gonna have
to watch
heal
your back. He's very good.
Yeah. I got you covered.
I'm gonna move.
Let James take a shot.
You move up one space. The creature's gonna use its held major action.
Oop.
It moved two, it's gonna move one more, and it's gonna hit you twice.
Ooh.
James, that's not that weird to you, but it should be weird to everyone else. This thing moved and is making two attacks on its turn.
Nice.
It's very weird.
You're going to take 12 points of damage, and you gain the bleeding condition.
That's not good.
You got bandages in your kit.
Yeah.
If you apply it, it heals you, and it prevents bleeding.
And it's a minor action to use equipment?
Yep.
Yeah.
Minor action for him to use that equipment. Different equipment, different things.
Different equipment, different things. Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. If you use a bandage, don't use all three of them because then it'll go away. But if you use two of them, they'll reset next encounter. Well, it's kind of a balancing act thing.
You want to clear the other two adds? Or, oh, yeah.
But it interrupted you. You still have another action, so you can shoot it.
I'm going to shoot him in the face.
Or you could use your axe and axe him a question.
No.
I don't think it matters. I think it's the same damage regardless.
I'm going to shoot this guy in the face.
Right, what's the shotgun damage?
2d6.
2d6, then you get the extra
six.
One. Yeah, I think that's the same. Shooter!
Shooter!
That's not great.
And you do add, what is it, technique to damage?
Technique! And then half your level, right?
No, just technique.
Okay.
So to damage.
15 plus... 9.
All right, so 24 points of damage.
Yes.
God damn. What did you add?
Plus 9?
The roll was 9.
Oh.
Oh,
no.
No,
no,
no. That's
no.
Your evasion save.
That's
your technique's
up
at the top left.
Oh, so 1.
Yep.
So 10.
Okay.
All right, 10 points of damage. You.
Still new to this, so.
You shoot the trench zombie in the face, and it is staggered. Like. You actually discover a mechanic that none of the players have encountered yet.
Fuck you, buddy.
Every enemy in the Codex has a special action you can perform to stagger it, where it just loses an action on it, like a major action.
And shooting it in the face was one this whole time?
For this,
God damn it.
For the trench zombie, you have to shoot it at point blank with a shotgun.
Oh.
You stumble it. But yeah, it
very specific.
Very specific.
Yeah.
I know
that's
what
good.
I must do.
It has
hilarious.
To be. It has to, well, not point blank. It's like
I know what I must
spaces.
Do. I just don't know if I have the strength to do
you
it.
You need ideal range shotgun. You knock it like right on its down. Ass, and it comes back standing up. This trench zombie is tougher than the ones you've fought before.
It's okay. I'll slash it. I'll slash it in a minute. We just need
for that third one.
Just need Dempsey to clear the rest
advantage.
Of the adds.
Sorry, I forgot to put more enemies. They've responded.
And then you do a bandage, 2 hit points, and then it prevents bleeding and burning. You don't have to really mark it down. You just keep your hit points.
Mm-hmm.
You got 2 uses. If you use all 3 uses of the bandage, it is used up and goes away forever. But if you only use 2, it like refreshes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Respawn.
So, you know.
All right. Who's next? What do you two?
You're going to shoot the zombie, right?
No, Doc needs to heal the tanky
heal.
Boy.
Okay, I will shoot the zombie in front of Doctor.
Okay.
What is that, 3d6?
With the shotgun?
No.
Your double barrel? Yeah.
I think I actually want to use the pistol because I don't have a lot of shotgun ammo left.
That's a good idea.
So,
1d6.
And you add technique?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, it's already here. Okay. So, 7.
Perfect.
7 points of damage. Bang, you finish that guy off.
Mm-hmm.
100 XP. And you get grit as well. Don't forget about that.
Oh, and a kill.
Yeah, and a kill with a firearm.
And I need 30 grit.
To use your ultimate, yeah.
Yeah.
But gunslinger, I think you need 8 grit.
12.
I hope it's written down somewhere.
6.
Oh, I have so much grit.
For the ammo inside.
How much do you have right now?
Oh, 6.
So just use up one every
time. 6 grit. How much do you need?
No. I have a lot.
How much do you have? So if you need to move and reload later, you can use Gunslinger to do both at the same time.
I have 23.
And heal. So Gunslinger's really good. All right. Odie.
I'm gonna
Dempsey's
get...
got another shot.
Yeah, Dempsey does have another shot.
Please shoot another zombie.
Yeah, I'll shoot... I can see the one in that window, right?
Yep.
Yeah, let me shoot that one.
All right, cool. Ooh. That should,
six.
That's exactly enough.
Yeah.
Your minimum damage kills.
Yeah.
More grit. More,
what we need.
It's another kill. It's more XP. All right, doctor.
Get me in front of... next to...
Nikolai.
Yeah.
Okay. Keep in mind, the enemy can hit you here, but you have partial cover, so you'll take half damage. And then shell shock. So you should be fine. Oh, wait. You could just move back.
Yeah, you can finish your move to back pedal.
Yeah. I'll heal him.
Oh, pretty good.
3d6.
3d6.
Mm-hmm. Unless you want to use your med kit.
Nah, I should be Gucci.
Okay.
Yeah. Cry.
That's 21 total.
Yeah.
21's pretty good, so it's your intellect plus...
5.
8. Plus eight, your intellect plus 4.
9 points of healing.
9 points of healing, James. Cool, thanks, Dean. and you want to move back to where you were?
You can even just step back that one square.
Yeah, step back that one square.
Okay, cool.
And that wouldn't harm anybody.
Good turn. That's everyone, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, and if you want to reload, don't forget you can use your minor action to reload your pistol instantly, because you fired half of your magazine. All right, back to the enemies. The zombies continue to flood the room, piling up against each other, proving ineffective, but also more appear. Okay, we're going to have only 3 attacks coming in, but you have partial cover against one of them, James. All right, you take 3 points of damage because of partial cover. Very good. Takeo, you take 2 points of damage.
Okay.
And Dempsey, one gets in your face and does 7 points of damage.
Okay.
The trench zombie... Nikolai, it is going to perform a combat maneuver against you. This is the first time you've seen this, James. This is, I mean, it's like Pathfinder combat maneuvers. It's going to roll, and you will get to decide. It's either going to deal you damage, or you'll take 0 damage, but it's going to grab you. Oh, shit. 24, so your total is 12. You're either going to take 12 points of damage, or it's going to grapple you. If it grabs, it can drag. Also, all that barbed wire wrapped around the trench zombie is going to cut into you if it starts grabbing you. So you're going to take a little damage either way. But it's going to be like a D6 or it's going to be like...
12.
12. It's up to you. Once you're grabbed, there are ways you can escape too. You can use your strength skill check, which I know you're really good at, or an athletic skill check.
I'll let it grab me.
Okay. You get grabbed as a major action. It's going to use its second major action to drag you back into the room at half speed. It literally drags you into the middle of the room. That other zombie who didn't get an attack off, now he does. He hits you for 2 points of damage. And as our tank's literally getting pulled away from the party into hell, the trench zombie uses its third major action on its turn, and it's going to hit you.
Stunned?
Oh, it was staggered. It lost its third one.
Yeah, I was going to say. It's got 3.
It's staggered.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep shooting in the face. Keep that staggered.
But, yeah, you've been pulled right in the middle of the enemy team. Zombies, normal zombies, have a feature called cold dead hands. Attack of opportunities don't exist in this game, but if you leave their space right now, they're going to hurt you because their grasping claws make it hard to run as they kind of box you in. If you've ever seen The Walking Dead, I'm sure you get it. I think that's it for the enemies. Back to y'all.
I have a question really quick. Secondary weapons, is it just the pistol or is it secondary weapons like my submachine gun that have that automatic quick draw where you draw them for free?
Not all secondary weapons. The submachine gun does not. The pistol does.
Submachine gun does not. So it takes...
It is a minor action if you want
to get
it out.
A minor action to whip her out. Okay.
You can just spray him down.
I mean, it's... Realistically, it's the same damage either way. Okay. I'll help out our boy here, you're going to have to clear some zomboids.
Protect the doctor. Don't let him take any damage.
Mm-hmm. That means that I am realistically going to have to... I could slash that guy, use my pistol on one of the normal zombies, next round, get in there to mix it up.
Mm-hmm. I can two shots.
Yeah.
You could shoot. If you shoot those zombies that are coming in from behind me kind of thing, I'll abandon my post and just run in right now to start slashing too. Through. Okay.
Don't forget we have explosives.
Ooh.
Multiple people have grenades and mines. Right. We also have PhD Flopper, both of you.
Oh, yeah, James is the only one that doesn't have it. Well, besides me.
Well, James, do you have a lethal... Do you have an equipment item in either of those slots?
Oh, the bandage.
Oh, yeah, that shouldn't be there, because those are for your lethal and tactical equipment. Mm-hmm. Ignore the bandage for now. I mean, we did find those other mines outside. No one took them.
He's got the shovel, is what he's got. You have the shovel.
Yeah.
I gave you the knife.
Yeah. Then yeah, you should probably take those landmines.
Yeah, so
I didn't know that you didn't have one.
Mm-hmm.
Cuz you got grenades, I got bouncing buddies.
Yep. That is a claymore, not like a bouncing buddy. That is like a more modern style claymore. The power divinium has dragged it back through time to a place it does not belong, but you now have it in your possession. So anyway. Cool.
I'm a strength up the zombie.
Yeah, you're going to break out? Good man. It's no longer staggered.
So, 10 strength. Plus 9 is
19. Okay, and I think I have to make an opposing roll.
Do you also add...
Or do I add brawn as well?
Yeah, you add brawn as well.
So, 23?
Yeah, 23.
Shit.
See, how many hit points do you have?
24 out of 42. So close.
Three more.
Oh, goddamn, that's a good roll.
You want me to let the zombie
I also
hit
rolled 23.
Take a couple hits for the team. I can take a hit
we,
for the team.
We rolled the same roll. So,
is it defender wins? Is it, meets or beats?
It is player favored.
Player favored.
Ooh.
So James wins. You win the tie.
Ooh.
Shit. Ooh. You can choose to take control of the grab or release it.
Drag him to me.
If you drag him, you'll move at half speed, but that's okay. And that'll be the end of your turn.
I grab and shoot at the same time?
You can grab him with your first major action and shoot him point blank with your second. Absolutely.
I'll do that.
Yeah.
But if you drag him this way, I can shoot
him. I was going to say, if you drag him in, we can, like, mess him up.
Mm-hmm.
Curb stomp him.
Plus, if you stay where... Well, if you move, you'll take some damage. If you stay where you are, you're going to get mauled.
You're going to get absolutely hammered if you stay there. But if you pull him back so that you're standing in front of the quick revive and he's in front of me and the doctor's just like behind you, the doctor can double barrel him in the face and I can slash the fuck out of him.
Yeah, the doctor's a breaching gun too. Or you have the...
I have a breach gun.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'll drag him back.
Okay.
It's a good call.
What the hell is a breach gun?
It's a type of shotgun. It's like...
Go one more.
You have like... It's a pump action. It's like here.
No. Where he's on the other side. So he's still protecting the doctor with his body.
Two.
So
what's your move speed? Five?
Seven? Yeah. Five? Oh, boy.
Shit, you can only move two, actually.
How's your move speed? Five.
Because he has the heaviest armor in the party.
Oh, yeah.
One, two.
That doesn't realistically help us much. That's okay, though.
If you want to stay where you were and just shotgun him, everyone can try to wipe out the undead around you.
Yeah, I'll just shotgun them.
Okay, cool. Good man. All right, roll damage. Someone bail him out. So you don't take damage from running away, which is good. That's disgusting.
And then your technique's just one, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So 14.
You deal 14 points of damage, and like you almost take its head clean off, but it just ducks out of the way, and you take its jaw. Oof.
Can staggered be applied repeatedly?
Yes.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah. Hmm? Well, you can shoot again. You've double tap.
Ooh.
Fuck him up, gamer. Let's go.
Keep going. Roll, roll.
Fuck
roll.
Him up, bro. You muscle man music. You know who else is the honored one. 10 more points of damage?
Yep.
Fuck yeah, dude. This thing is way tougher than the average trench zombie that we've been fighting, and like, the lower you get it, the more this like etheric purple flame is boiling off of its skin. Something odd about that one for sure. But good turn. It's staggered. Someone else. Someone help him out.
Do you want to step forward and clear? Because you can, if you just, well, actually, from where you are, you can hit those two
behind him.
Zombies, right?
Yeah. The two can't hit the one behind him. You can hit these.
Well, yeah. Those are behind him.
Oh, my bad. My bad. Yeah.
You could clear those two without moving.
Yeah.
Cool. Fuck him up, doctor. Just don't roll a one.
Bet.
Five head.
Roll the first one.
Good.
A
100 XP.
Did.
A.
And don't forget. Well, actually, you're already full on. You're full on resolve. So if we need your ultimate, you can heal the whole party.
Mm.
All right. You knocked up both. Got some XP for it.
Okay. That leaves you and I in an awkward position here.
Well, I need to be hit anyway for the team.
Yeah, you need to be hit. I don't.
Yeah. Sorry, bud.
I'll slash, of course, the guy behind me. That's well dead.
Good man.
Can you go get the other one next to?
And is your honor full?
It is one off. I'm now at 25 out of 30.
Oh my god.
Extra crispy.
So the question is, do I remain here and prep my last attack? Because those two zombies are going to pour in. I can get that last attack on their round, pop my ult, dash in for James.
How hard does this thing? Well, it's staggered right now, right?
So it's staggered right now, and it is grappled by James and does seem to be rather infatuated with him.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully I don't get hit. I think that's probably the best course of action. If you want to blast away your front guy and then the guy that's going to come try to hit Odie.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
I'll hold.
You're on? Or?
Well, I need to let someone hit me for the team.
They'll be fine without your sacrifice.
There'll be more zombies coming.
Can I see that one back there?
No, it has full cover from you. You can see it, but not well enough to shoot it.
Okay. Well, then let me shoot the one in the window first.
Fuck yeah.
If you clear them both, another zombie will come through that door next round.
Cool.
Like, for sure.
You got that, King.
And, I'll shoot the other one, too.
Okay.
Dead.
Cool. That's XP, grit,
and kills.
Your challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
And how much
we're farming
so far?
Oh, I need to reload.
You haven't gotten
any
because you haven't gotten a kill.
Yeah, they're not spending
it's
any.
It's per player, and then at the end of combat, we decide if we're going to share.
Okay. They're just earning it so far.
It's a minor action to reload.
We keep
Yeah,
it's spent. And you can't, from my understanding, you can't spend in a round.
You can spend it during combat.
But it doesn't transfer from your combat to your available. So, like right now, even though I've got 300 in the bank, I could not grab Quick Revive this round.
Well, you don't have enough for Quick Revive, so...
I would 100% have enough, because it's 1,500.
Oh, you can spend
I've got three in my combat total, 300 in my combat total,
you can
and
spend it from either.
Okay.
And you can level up right now if you're crazy, you know, but...
Well, I wouldn't level up
from
that.
It you
would
wouldn't.
Just get
they
me the
would.
Perk.
What does it say? You want some Quick Revive? cool.
I am saying I want some Quick
Good
Revive.
Good turn. And then you're holding
I want
your,
a Sodi.
You're holding your last action?
Yes,
cool.
I'll hold my last action.
These zombies come running in.
Swing. He's dead.
Which means the second one gets in.
Yeah, you know.
And he's going to smack you.
I understand.
7 points of damage.
Ooh.
God damn. This one is actually just going
to
stay where it is and hit you. You take 6 points of damage, James. As more of the dead start to enter the room.
Ooh. That's a nice number you got there.
Yeah.
How are hit points looking?
Nine.
Not awesome.
I'm sitting pretty.
I'm okay. Yeah, well, you know.
I've got 5 hit points.
The trench zombie has lost one of its major actions, but some strange power has given it one more than it usually would have anyway. So it's going to take 2 actions right now.
Yeah.
It's going to try to dominate your grab because you guys are about equally matched.
How low are you?
So go ahead and roll posed for me.
Okay, I'll heal you.
I want to just pop your roll.
Yeah.
And heal everybody.
Because
it will not bring either
of us
get? Up half. Just about guaranteed.
I got 22. What's that total? You get 21.
Oh, you get 22.
God damn! Player favored. You keep the
you
grab.
You win, baby.
That's ridiculous.
God,
that is literally exactly 22.
You guys are literally
22.
Evenly matched. What are you at, wait. 8?
No, you're right. It's exactly 22.
Twinsies.
What does he add?
Adds 4?
He has the 4 and the... Or he has, like, a bonus, and then he has his brawn.
So oh, it's so more. There's so more, yeah. That's what?
26.
Oh,
because you have 10 brawn.
Yeah.
10 brawn plus the 4.
Brawn, 10
4 brawn, 10 skills.
You fucking dominated. Right, because Colby got the lead.
That's
power
right.
Last,
that's
last
right.
Game. No, you control the grab, and he's pissed about it, but
I'm
he's just going to
tell him no one's smacking him.
Good. Yeah. You're he's gonna hit you again since he can't break the grab. And that's 6 points of damage.
Oh!
You would take the bleeding condition,
but
you're immune to bleed,
baby.
From your
bandage. Yeah, I'm gonna pop my ult.
Are you really?
It is now player's turn, right?
Oh, it's healing time?
It's healing time.
Yeah.
Alright, everyone's in range for healing. Wonderful. Yeah, it's back to y'all.
I'm popping my ult.
How much does it do?
2d6 healing per round, right? Or is it more than that?
I think
per round.
Per round for 5 rounds.
Oh shit!
Area heals everyone within 4 spaces,
nice.
Which is exactly where you are. I guess you're with 4.
Is that definitely not it?
Yeah.
So we're gonna lose shell shock and
five
way
rounds.
Of dying, but
yeah.
It'll be worth it.
It's for 5 rounds.
Well, yeah,
D6.
We can't.
Mm-hmm.
We can watch. Well, there's very little chance that 2d6 is going to bring me above half hit points and James above half. There's no chance it brings James above half.
Oh, how much healing?
5.
5 heals for everyone, including you, Doctor.
I'm full.
Yeah, right, because you're a genius. All right, well, that was your free... It was a free action to activate that.
Yeah.
And you have the rest of your turn. Go for it.
James is in incredible position. Did you already add 5 to your...
Yeah. Back to 8.
Eight HP.
That's why.
Oh fuck!
You've already healed James this round.
Why Nikolai
too, so
popped
you
their
can't
ult?
Can't do anymore.
I can't do anymore.
But you
what
can.
Do is heal you.
I'm okay. Shoot this. Just do 2 shots, right? Shoot the zombie that I'm facing, and then shoot the one in your window, and that'll free up Dempsey a little bit too.
I could, but I could also help James because I have a shotgun too, and he'll just have one.
Just don't get in next
Does
to it.
Does stagger stack?
It doesn't.
I didn't think so. Okay.
Okay.
There's no need.
But someone has to re-up stagger this round anyway.
James will do it.
Good,
James.
Good,
James
right.
Like shooting things in the face.
Yeah,
he's
shoot it 3 times.
But
yeah.
How many shots do you have in the chamber?
He's 6, and he's used 2.
He's used 2, so he's still got 4 shells.
So if I shoot the 2 by our side.
And then I'm going to pop my ult and dash in and slash the fuck out of that big guy.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
I mean, I could just do a shotgun.
All right, shoot, well...
And hit both of those, so they're within range.
All right, you going to shoot 2 of them?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Which ones are you going for?
These 2?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
And because it's a lot more
shooting
that I will...
Gotta make sure you don't lose any health. First one?
5.
Bro,
why is this +6 on this side? I don't know why.
Oh, is it plus? Because it should just be plus your technique, right?
I thought I did +6 because of the special other thing.
No.
No, because then 5.
5?
Yeah.
Shit.
I'll just hit that one for the window.
With the shotgun?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you roll on the die?
2 ones.
Wait, why is your shot?
2 ones.
I only have 3.
And you're not in optimal range.
Well, mine's a double barrel. That's why my damage is so much higher. Yeah.
I free you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
At least the one next to me is
bang,
dead.
Bang. Oh, but the other one's going to come hit you, dude.
Dempsey's right.
Dempsey's
there.
Got it.
Yeah, is it player turn?
Yeah, it's our turn.
Yeah.
Let me real quick. I'm going to pop ult, and I'm going to dash in, and I'm going to hit the big guy.
Okay, Path of Sorrows. We
and
charge in.
You two are still down, so I still get the... Right.
Huh?
I still have...
Yeah. James and I are still well below half hit points.
So I still get the shell shot.
Yes, you still do
I'll
get the shell shot. Hold on.
On your
Give
turn,
me a second
yeah.
here. Give me a second here. Because that's
oh,
2
fuck.
Standard ult, half hit points, and then my perk. Okay.
Yeah, because you use your minor action. Let's go. Oh, I love this.
Disgusting.
10.
The spirit of Zhao Fei.
20. Yeah, 29. 32 points of damage.
Holy Christ.
That doesn't count as flanking by any chance, does it?
No, unfortunately. You have to draw a clear line through the target.
I've got 7 on my move speed. Oh, would stepping one being, more over...
You get an extra d6.
Another 2. 34, baby. Yeah.
Actually, you could get here and then move back into the corner, and that'd be your whole move speed.
Sure.
Wait, you have 2 more move speed from your ult.
Yeah.
So you have 9.
Yeah, I've got 9.
1, 2, 3. 9? Yeah, bang, bang.
Yeah. Does that give me another
D6? That's another one from flank, yeah. Crazy get stupid.
I gotta get all my matching D6s.
Yeah.
34 plus 5, 39, baby.
So add 7 more.
I'm switching D6s.
Dude, you fucking rolled that guy. You just did 39 points damage. He is very low, but doesn't die, and you back up. Okay.
That was disgusting.
You, and then Dempsey. Shotgun. I think you might finish him.
It's 9.
3 shells.
Damn, you didn't finish him, but he's staggered. 1 more shot with double tap.
Come on, baby.
Did you do it?
That's 10.
10. Negative 7. That'll do.
Yeah.
You put the shotgun right to his chest and like
open him up.
Pump it against him just from his momentum as he's squirming around, and you put a hole right through the trench zombie's breastplate. The corpse falls, and the real enemy of the encounter is revealed.
I'm sorry, what?
As the roiling, as the roiling purple smoke emerges from the corpse, and you see before you this like spectral entity. It is a wailing spirit. It is a phantom, which was possessing the body of that trench zombie. The elite enemy's gone, and there won't be any more.
And that's
I told you he was
250 trench zombie.
Huh? That's 250 XP for you. And you get Fury.
Woo!
But in its stead, there is now a phantom on the field. You see it kind of like flickering before you as it crawls out of this corpse. It's like there's a ghost right in front of your eyes. And for the next 6-ish seconds, it looks like it might be corporeal.
Okay. You got 1 more shot, right? Because double tap
blast that guy.
Lets you repeat a shot once around or whatever.
Yeah.
So shoot one of the normal zombies, I suppose.
I'll shoot the one right across.
Dark bluey.
Mm-hmm.
Might as well just clear him out of the way.
I need to be tracking everyone's kills, right?
No, just yours.
Just
yours.
With firearms.
That's more than enough.
Okay, yeah.
He's 100 XP.
You paint the back wall with that other guy. 100 XP and Fury.
The Kurt Cobain School of Art.
Stop. Christ.
Oh.
Jesus.
We hear painting walls with shotguns.
Stop. Oh, man. Too soon.
Too soon.
And Dempsey.
Like you ever do the
last
guy.
One.
Okay, we're protecting. We're babysitting back here, so.
Oh, and James, you didn't use your minor action. I'd recommend if you want, you could reload 2 shots for your shotgun.
I'll do that.
Nice.
They're both dead.
Kaplap, kaplap. Nice. Bang, bang. Grit, honor.
Like,
or no, sorry, grit, XP.
Yep.
The likes. You get it.
Yes.
Guys, we're doing pretty well, but the main enemy was not that elite bruiser that we were expecting. It is the ghost that came out of its skin. And now the ghost is kind of like staggered and seems like temporarily weakened. But in moments, it will be back at full strength. So.
The dead.
Like Snickers.
That's weird. Snickers are just fine. There's nothing wrong with Snickers.
This banshee, or not the banshee, this phantom is going to move across. No, it can't go over there. It goes out the window into this zombie as it's crawling in. And you see the zombie's eyes turn the stark purples. The flames begin to roil off of its shoulders. It possessed the next available enemy.
He has so many possessions or whatever, and then we can slaughter him. Perhaps.
But it's the enemies. Only 2 enemies in the room. And a couple more about to appear elsewhere. Nikolai, you're going to take a hit.
Ooh.
You take 2 points of damage.
Remember, your toughness just healed you 2 points of damage.
Which of you is more injured?
He's at 8 hit points. I have...
He's less, I guess.
He's got less. He's lowest.
That other one's going to hit you twice, the one possessed by the phantom.
By 2 hit points. I've got
You
10.
May not survive. Oh, shit. You take 4 and then 5, 9 points of damage. Are you down? Yeah.
No! Adding plus 2 every round or no?
Oh, you have toughness.
I reminded him of yeah. that this round. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he's been doing it other rounds, but...
I'm going to say that because of no.
Shame. All right, yeah. Sorry, James. I know Ian reminded you, but in the future, if you're below half health, you have 2 health regen at the beginning of your turn.
Would have been nice to know.
I'm sorry.
Well, I've been saying it to you a couple of times.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's not necessarily really your fault. You just jumped in.
Yeah.
Thank you for jumping in. You're going to lose your double tap.
Negative 1.
So you don't go negative. You just stay at 0. Oh. You lose your double tap perk. I'm sorry. Yeah. Every round, if you go unconscious, you lose the most recent perk you bought, and every round after that, you'll lose more.
So we need to give all the perks to the doctor, because...
Forever alive.
Yeah.
So James, the way this works, it's just like zombies. You are now prone, you're not unconscious, but you fall to the ground. You can only use a one-handed secondary weapon. And you can move like 2 spaces, or you can shoot or reload. Those are the only 2 things you can do in your turn. I'm going to ask you to roll saving throws when it gets to your turn, but your teammates have to pick you up. Or maybe, miraculously, you'll roll well enough that you stand up on your own.
Okay.
We'll get you, buddy. Don't worry. All right, that's all the enemies this round. Back to y'all.
Doc's ultimate does not res people.
It doesn't.
Above,
but
right?
Doc can still go revive him with a medicine skill check.
Yeah. Roll your healing real quick.
Actually, reviving him is a full round action, so...
So you could go in partially.
That's a lot better than last time.
That's 7, baby.
Woo!
Okay.
Does he still gain the heals even though he's down?
No.
Okay.
He's incapable of taking or healing or damage, so...
Does it aid with a saving throw?
It does not. Hmm. You have, like, your HP doesn't exist when you're incapacitated. It's just your death saves.
And when you revive someone, how many hit points do they come back with?
1, unless you have...
1, unless you got quick revive.
Quick revive, or, like, you have some powers that give health and heal at res. So. Yeah.
I don't have that.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Well, we should probably start mobbing up on our lad here. I will clear some adds for us.
And I'll do you guys a favor, so it doesn't look identical. This is the zombie possessed by the phantom.
Okay. I will slash phantom zomboy.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's in my melee range.
Mm-hmm.
And it's what I do.
James still counts as below half health for the purposes of your
yes.
abilities.
Yeah, I figured as much. That's right. I reroll 1s on damage rolls.
Oh, stopping power.
Just 1s. Oh. That is 10, 18... 20, 26, 26 plus 3, 29 points of damage.
You reduce it to 1 hit point.
Well, I guess I know what I'm doing for my second action.
Yeah, you finish it. even a normal zombie becomes at least a moderately threatening creature as soon as the phantom slips into its skin.
Does the phantom... provide extra EXP when you destroy it?
It does
or
not.
Is it just 100?
It's just a zombie.
Okay.
You cut the corpse in half and the phantom slips out of it again, and it seems like staggered and distressed. It is corporeal for 1 round.
Ooh.
After you kill its host.
Okay.
After that, it will be immune to your damage. All damage.
Shoot that guy.
Hey, shoot that guy. Good turn. Who's next?
Doc, do you want to run in up next to us and then blast that ghoul in the face?
I can.
It'd be a super dope thing to do.
You can just move over 2, right? And you'll be able to see him.
But if you go the full 3, you're in the shotgun's extra
and you'll be able
range.
To full heal to full round him next round as
yes.
well.
Exactly.
Okay. But if you don't kill it,
it's still not even in melee range of her though.
Yeah.
There's both me and Downed Boy in the way.
Never mind.
And
shell shock... realistically, if I understand the mechanics of the game, mm-hmm. Phantom Lad is going to go to another zombie, not mm-hmm. trying to slash somebody else.
Which I will still be.
It does mean, though, that you're going to have to like step over to the side and
so
shoot the
get...
light blue zombie so yeah. that it doesn't get it. It doesn't get it, Doc.
Mm-hmm.
Need shotgun.
Or I guess James could shoot that one.
Because that's in the happy range of the shotgun, I get another D6, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you're rolling 3D6 plus 3.
How fun. Oh, how fun.
That's pretty decent. That ain't bad.
9, 11, 14. Yeah.
Okay, 14 points of damage. People. You... Oh, this is the... I'm looking at the wrong stat block.
The ghosty goo.
You almost kill it in one shot. That was pretty good. The ghost itself, the phantom, is not very powerful. Oh, you just have to isolate it in those moments of weakness.
Can I try to shoot?
You actually can. You're prone, you could shoot with your pistol.
So hold on a second, though, right? What's your passive damage, James? It's your technique.
One.
What I'm saying, you got a handgun. It's not a great chance, but a decent chance of just doming the zombie in front of you.
Yeah.
And if our lad Dempsey moves over and gets real nice and close,
kill all the hosts
with their double barrel, that would be a greater chance of ending the phantom than you using your handgun round.
Okay, so try and kill the other one.
I would maybe we let Dempsey just go first and we hold your turn for last.
Just kill all the hosts. Yeah, okay. Dempsey.
Can you explain
close
to me how
distance.
The gunslinger works against six, so it takes 6 grit and a major action, is that what?
Yeah, so it's kind of thing like while you move, it like lets you use a movement, and while you're moving you get a reload and you get a heal burst. So it's a D6 plus
Okay, so it's not gonna help.
Is your ultimate ready? You've been building grit like mad.
Oh, I've been building because I haven't been hit grit recently.
Oh yeah. Yeah, you're old.
3 rounds.
You've been
it's been 2 rounds.
2 rounds?
2 rounds, so you're at 5.
I'm 3 off from my ult.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Then you move and shoot.
Yeah.
And don't use your handgun. Use your minor action to switch.
You switch to the shotgun.
You didn't almost kill it, but you did good damage to it. My bad. I had the wrong stat block out, so I had the wrong health.
Yeah, I'm gonna move. I'm gonna take my minor action, move up right behind the doctor. And
or your major action. Yep.
Shoot that guy.
Yeah, blast that guy.
Cool.
So 3d6.
Yep. Because Nikolai's laying on the ground, it does not have cover.
Yeah, I was gonna say you shouldn't have the cover.
12
ain't bad.
12 ain't bad at all.
It's better than 2.
The creature is looking pretty hurt. You guys are shooting a ghost, and it's like the mist is like dissipating from the damage you're dealing to it. It's a very strange thing. All right, you're the last man. If you want to kill a mook or take a shot at the big bad, it's up to you.
I mean, it's almost, I don't know.
It says light damage. Is that just
1d6 plus your technique?
You think it's worth it to just shoot at the phantom? And...
It's probably better to kill the mook if you can.
I think max damage right now, James is looking at 7 points.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and we don't know how long. How close
you shoot that one next to you. Hey,
that's enough.
That's enough.
That's
you
what
kill,
we needed.
You had a 1 in 3 chance.
The
of
doctor's
killing
safe.
That zombie. Unfortunately,
baby is safe.
You don't build any fury while you're unconscious. Sorry.
And you don't get any toughness healing.
But I need you to roll vigor saving throw. So roll 3d6 and add your saving throw bonus,
which is your valor.
Which is 5.
Yeah. So go ahead and roll that. Now look at your vigor total.
13.
13. Oh, you got 13.
Dude, you got 13 exactly.
Ooh. James, what is it with you in rolling exactly what you need?
Woo! You
He's not
succeed
a man of
your first.
Making people sweat.
Succeed your first vigor save. If you succeed 3 of them, you'll stand up on your own at 1 HP. If you fail 3 of them, you'll fall unconscious until the end of the battle and no one will be able to wake you up. But you won't die. There's no dying in this game.
I still get XP from the
Unless you party wipe.
You don't get XP. And all the XP that's in your, you only earn 250 XP, huh?
Yeah.
I'm up to 350.
350.
Well, with that zombie you just shot, right? Or no, you cleared another.
Unfortunately, when you fall unconscious, you lose all the XP you've earned during that encounter.
What about the one he just shot right now?
Well, it doesn't count for anything.
You
would gain it, then lose it, right?
So.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. We'll share at the end of this.
Yeah. Sure. Everyone will share. So,
unless
but hey,
sharing
that was really
means
clutch.
That I can't get quick revive.
It is the rest of the enemies now.
I have enough that you can get quick revive and we can.
Hey, they're good. Perfect.
These ones, one runs up to you but can't hit you. The other one can hit you, Dempsey. You'll take 3 points of damage.
Okay. It's not a big deal. Yeah. You're okay.
I was mostly full, so.
This one runs over here and
not
is
baby.
Going to attack the doctor.
No!
This one's going to run up and attack Takeo.
Four, less, four, less, four,
and the phantom is going to possess the one attacking you right now.
No!
Doc. It doesn't look good.
That wouldn't be the closest one, though. The closest one would be mine.
And
it had to move 2 squares to get to Odin.
Takeo does
no, you're
more
right.
damage. Yeah.
No, you're right. It doesn't matter how much damage it deals, you're more hurt.
That is
it's
also
gonna,
true.
It's going to focus you down.
I am also more hurt
so
than
actually,
the doc is.
So actually,
you're fine.
But you're still
going to
take a hit.
-4.
6 points of damage.
Damn.
Fuck! Damn it. So good. So close.
Again.
Just a good roll. But the other guy is going to hit you twice as it's possessed by the phantom. Ooh, 6 and 7. 12 points of damage.
I'm okay. I can take that.
You're okay. And you'll get more healing on your turn, on the doc's turn.
Yeah.
All right, sorry, Odie. Back to y'all. More enemies appear, but no one of them are going to attack yet.
Let me slash before you roll your healing, just in case.
That's fine.
2 ultimate damaged.
Hurt. All right.
You wouldn't happen to be below half all of a sudden. Yeah, I didn't think so.
I am.
Yeah, I'm counting you. You're helping me greatly.
I mean, if you want me to just take a couple hits, I'll do it, but like...
I slash the phantom.
Okay.
Save that
one. Yeah, you slash at the possessed. You might kill that zombie in one hit.
Ooh, that's good. Ooh.
God, the damage build. I love it.
That is 27.
27! It has 3 hit points remaining.
Odie, could you shoot it and finish it off?
It'll have partial cover from Takeo, but...
I can shoot it.
Yeah, James, you shoot it. It doesn't
hey,
have cover
buddy.
Against you.
Yeah.
We need 3, baby. Yeah.
You're crawling around on the floor. I love when players are like, cover me, I'm reviving you. And then you shoot your
today.
Stupid fucking pistol. Yeah, you kill
clack,
zombie being possessed, and the phantom again slips out of the dead, just out of the bones.
Hey there, Delilah. Mm. I got one more slash.
One ready. More slash. Go for it, buddy.
And I saved my minor action for this one for my extra D6.
Steadied. Sweet.
Ooh.
Oh, fuck.
No one's rolled. That is 10, 20, 25, 29, 32 points of damage.
32? It has 34 hit points.
Damn. Does it regen when it possesses?
It does not regen. It just had 60.
Oh, okay.
And
it
I
had.
Gave
okay.
you guys the wrong.
So it's got health. 3 hit points again.
It's 2 hit points.
2 hit points.
So if I just
Dempsey,
move out of the
way. Would you like to do the honors, I suppose?
It's going to have. Actually, Dempsey, you can't shoot it. There are too many allies in the way. Oh. It has full cover against you right now.
You have to shoot it, Doc. I have to shoot it.
It'll have partial cover from you, but that's doable.
That's just half damage, right?
Mm-hmm.
I just shoot the shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
Your shotgun gets an extra D6 because you're within 2 squares.
Happy squares.
Happy
squares.
Happy squares.
Happy squares.
It's okay.
That's
you
way more than
flash
2.
through its essence, and as it's trying to accumulate and find a new host, a shotgun comes under your armpit.
You healing. That's fine.
Your Eight. Ear rings as it goes off literally next to your torso, and the ghost explodes back into the ether. Gone.
8 healing.
Be gone, winch.
Woo!
Odie, you get 300 XP.
Woo!
Nice.
That was the enemy for the encounter. The showdown has ended. No more undead will spawn.
Cool. You want to just clear out? First you want to just take your second shot, clear out that one right in front of you?
Yeah. I mean, it hurt me.
It's probably the best call.
It hurt me.
Use your miner to do a reload.
I mean, I still have, like...
Yeah, but the miner would put 2 shells in. It would just undo this round. And there's... You're not doing anything else. That's way more than enough.
Okay.
100 XP, baby.
That guy's dead. All right. Good turn. Good turn. Roll a vigor save for me. And then Dempsey, it's on to you.
Okay, I'm going to kill both of those guys.
Good man.
That's 21 total.
With the pistol.
Yep. So you get the shit.
3 total.
Hey, that's 2 saves. You might actually just stand up on your own. Vigor's your good save, though, as
it's only DC 13.
A brawn
plus five
and dollar
on your roll.
Build.
Odds are in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
You Gucci.
The problem is usually not that you're gonna go unconscious. It's that you've downtime, you know?
Yeah, you're not actively helping your team.
And
you
lose
your
perks.
You lose mm-hmm. active XP.
If you had four perks, you know, you'd have lost three of them already, which is pretty brutal.
Yeah.
I also reload my pistol.
Oh, good man. Okay. Guys, that's everyone. The last of the enemies are in the room already.
No, you leave that doctor alone.
I'm just a baby.
It's too late.
These ones rush you, but only one can hit you.
Like piranhas, they smell blood in the water.
Okay. Takeo, 2 points of damage. I 2 points of damage, doctor. You don't take it.
I did nothing.
4 points of damage.
Okay. I want to shoot the blue
That's one. Another one.
All right.
Shoot the blue one.
All right. James is starting off strong.
It's okay. I'm going to slash.
It's okay. Roll bigger save for me.
Oh. That is.
I think it's a fail.
That's a fail. That's 11.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a fail. That's okay.
Damn, son.
The combat's about to end anyway.
It's okay. I'm in melee range of both of those two guys. I'll just clear those two. You clear the back two. You res them.
Yeah.
First one's... Hold on. I got to reroll three ones here to tell if that normal zombie's dead or not. Mm-hmm. The first one's dead.
Okay.
And the second one, threatening my doc, is also very dead.
They both die. Good man.
Clear out those assholes.
Okay, and that's it. That's the end. Okay, so James, you've not been here, so you don't know how it works, but everyone else does. Any number of players can choose to split the XP they earn during that encounter, so that's why you have three totals in your XP box. The combat total is what everything that you are earning during the fight right now. At the end of the fight, you get to put all that in your available.
Seven.
Available is what's in your wallet. Combat total is what you're earning on the job.
How much?
So.
This combat, 1,000. Or, oof. Yeah, 1,000. Oof.
Oof. 2,400 total.
2,400. Split that, 600 each?
600 a piece.
I also
more
have
650 to...
available. If
available doesn't get split.
You
that's already.
That
oh, you can't.
That's already,
already
in your wallet. Combat total's the new shit. Yeah.
I'm more than happy to split 600 a pop.
Yep.
Me it only too. Puts me down by 100. And James, right. that means you get 600 XP instead of nothing.
Nothing. Good man. Sorry you lost double tap.
Do we heal again? Because it's still...
Yeah, you guys get the remainder of the healing from your ultimate.
Three more rounds?
Two more
rounds. Yeah. 16?
Okay, everyone gets 16 more HP from a better tomorrow, which is good. Sweet.
Do I get it? Or...
Yes. Yeah, everyone.
Because you're picked up.
Yeah. Well, I have my ult now.
That puts me above half hit points, unfortunately. But also fortunately.
And you're still half.
I'm at 16 hit points.
Nice.
I can heal again with the medkit because that's probably the best thing.
Yeah, now that we're in downtime, you can use medkit.
That's
great. Yeah, if you wanna treat his wounds, you can do that.
And I'll assist you to give you an extra DC.
Who's had their wounds treated recently?
Five. Just James on the in the combat.
That was a field dressing.
Yeah,
but I mean the out of combat heals from the medicine checks. Because remember, you only get one of those between.
That's right,
rests.
Between rests. I think we only did them before the rests.
Yeah, we haven't.
I think we did
right.
one
because we only between. Did that one combat after the
yeah.
rest.
And we kept our hit points at the what they were.
Cool.
Yeah, so you're clear to heal.
Just
so
you can catch up, James.
Do you need an aid?
The doctor. Or anyone can do a heal
or
check.
Or take the aid for five.
Yeah. Five.
Each player can only get one low heal per battle, and each player can get one high heal outside of battles, but you have to take a rest between those.
22?
And I'll tell you the total. This is not what you get. 32? Goddamn.
I'm putting too much.
No worries, I got you.
So 32 for Nikolai?
No, that's 7, so it's 14 plus your intellect.
14 plus 5, 19.
19 points of healing.
Nice.
Sizably better.
Mm-hmm. So what, you're at 35?
And once again, Quick Revive reduces it from a full round action as well, right?
Yes. Quick Revive makes it a major action to revive someone.
So worth it.
Gives them, if you have Quick Revive and you're unconscious,
mm-hmm.
When you get revived, you have 50% of your max health immediately.
Yeah.
But you lose the perk either way. So,
right. 1,500. I spend that on quick revive.
I also spend that on quick revive.
Okay.
At 1300?
1500. But if you have the occult skill, you do get a discount.
Yeah.
Which, sorry, it has been changed slightly. It's 50 per skill point in occult. So how many points do you have? Okay, so you have 150 point discount on that. So it's 1350 for you to buy it. You buying it?
Yeah.
Are you buying it?
I did, yes.
So that's 2850, I believe.
2850 for James's tally.
Yeah, James, the party spent 2850 XP right now. So.
Is there anywhere around here to buy ammo?
For what kind of weapon?
Yes.
You can't. There's nowhere you can buy it for pistols right now. Uh-huh. If you want a shotgun, you can go back to the trench we just came through. Mm-hmm. Remember, there was that shotgun chalk buy.
I don't remember, but.
Okay.
I'll go back there.
I wasn't here.
No, no, we did it during the session, T.
Was it?
Yeah, James should have been paying attention.
Yeah.
The 650 XP.
Remember, James needed XP, and then he was like, shit, I only have 100.
18 ammo for it.
Yeah, I'll go back and I'll get ammo.
Oh, good man.
You want to get ammo for your shotgun, too, then?
Yeah.
That double barrel is going to be better than just the rifle 50. On the wall.
Yeah.
650.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wait. For the double barrel team?
Well, I need ammo of some kind.
It's not going to give you ammo for that. That's a heavy shotgun.
Ooh.
Because I have... I have six shots left for my pistol and four shots left for my shotgun. Or three shots left for my shotgun.
Does anyone have any pistol ammo?
Yeah, you want 10 rounds for the pistol?
That would be great.
Yeah, fucking take it. I don't care.
Okay.
I don't need any.
Yeah.
I haven't shot a gun once.
Mm-hmm.
Reload my pistol.
And I've still got four rounds in the mag, I guess. So pistol's worth just holding on to.
So, James, did Colby write down how Brutal Strike works? Just curious. When you use it, it just like buffs a melee attack that you perform.
Yeah. You cost 8 fury.
Yeah. You deal 2d6 bleed damage, and then you heal half of that plus your brawn. And it causes the enemy to bleed. Yeah. Cool. Just wanted to make sure. All right. Guys, that was an outbreak that we just cleared up in the first room. We bought some quick revive. Yeah. What's the party's XP that we've all spent, James, since you just added to it? Added 2850.
Added 2850, but then you got the shotgun ammo as well. That was another 650.
Oh, that's another 650.
2850 goes to 3435 even.
3500 we just added.
So whatever that number is, plus 3500.
That'll be 15,000.
That's what I was in trouble with.
Oh, I can see it.
Yeah.
Colby, what the fuck?
I've seen Colby's handwriting.
That's the 12,000. It's either 475.
That's a 9. Okay.
So it'll be at 16,000.
Yeah. Someone get a calculator and add 3,500.
I'm pretty sure it's 16,400.
Yeah, my phone's about to die.
Goddamn, I love math.
16,475 plus another 3,500.
No,
I got it. I got it. T's right. It's 16,475.
Yeah, that's where we're at.
Okay. Very good, T.
16,475.
Yeah, you do math in the tens of thousands sometimes.
Yeah. Daily? And now for astronomy.
And then, James, you also have to add the 650 to your total spent on the front side. What does that bring you to?
I'm at 3,000. I level up.
Hey. That's what I'm looking for.
All right.
4,050.
Oh, okay. So you were already level 3.
Can I still buy a rifle?
Really?
Does it say level 3 at the top there?
It says level 2.
Let me see that.
Let's see.
The total spends. Did you spend 2850?
No, I marked that down because that was what the.
Oh, sorry. That's that's on. Okay, so you got to remove that 2850.
No, so you just broke 3,000. I think
you just broke. Which levels you up?
3,400 now.
That was already on there.
Yeah.
Okay. Huh, Colby. I'm curious. All right.
The only bad part, the revolving door.
Unfortunately, yeah. Go ahead and just add 650 to that. and...
Which is what I was going to do, which is
450. Yeah, 4,050. And yeah, you're level 3. We can level you up right now. It doesn't take very long. It's quick enough that the game's designed. You can do it in fucking combat if you're crazy.
1d6 for life, right?
1d6 for HP. Did you level up?
Yes.
Yay, good one. Plus that brawl. You're rough on behind a little bit. One. How close are you to leveling?
7 mag, baby.
What's your total score?
5.
I don't know if anyone else, because these are the tally marks that I have marked. I don't know if anyone else marked
it. Is
it
on the back?
No.
Enoch didn't pay attention to any of it.
Because there's only Enoch. The 5 tally marks that I had.
Well, I know what he spent.
Spent 950.
He hit the Wonder Fizz and he hit the box.
Oh, yeah. He hit the Wonder Fizz.
So that's 2,450.
Okay, so...
2,450 plus 500.
Plus whatever you had spent.
Okay. Yeah. So 2950.
Oh, never mind.
Oh, shit. You're so close.
So you can only have 2 weapons, right? Like 2 main weapons?
Yeah, you have a primary and a secondary.
Because I'm really tempted to buy a rifle again because I still have 48 fucking shells for a rifle.
Yeah.
There is a submachine gun in the 3rd generator room. And that could take your secondary slot, so you wouldn't have to get rid of the shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
Replace your pistol.
Or we could all go back to the mystery box, and if you got 950, you could hit that.
I have 1250.
You go hit the mystery box.
Where's the mystery box?
Get something.
Back at generator 2.
Which we're next to.
Yeah.
We could. Whatever. We could get an outbreak.
That's okay.
Waddle, waddle, waddle.
All right.
So how do you do that?
Okay, so both of you level up, so you get 1d6 HP plus your brawn.
Yeah.
And then you get the general talent.
Like 9.
The doctor specific one when you go to the you get a plus mm-hmm. one of those
and you get that for your current so health as well
or hear me out
god and damn
what a man
what's your current health at
well, I don't miss all my shots
you do you
so now mm-hmm. it's gonna be 44
I would recommend your
blood. I know I'm a big brain boy
good man you get an ability score adjustment so you can increase one of your 4 main stats so valor's good for your saving throws techniques for your damage yeah you're going for the range damage good man okay you get skill points so at the top of the skill chart there's a thing that says intellect plus whatever right
yeah plus 2
okay so your intellect is 2. So you get 4 skill points you can add to anything you want. There's no cap for how many you can have. Do you want to know what any of the skills do? Because I know you're new.
Yeah.
So strength is for, well, picking up and moving things, but also grappling, shoving, and tripping. Those are all the combat maneuvers. Athletics is for like moving through difficult terrain, like mud and swimming, climbing. Medicine is pretty straightforward. Occult is for like if you want to look at a magical creature and try to understand how it works, like that phantom we fought. But also it gives you a discount when you use perk machines and the pack-a-punch. Insight is like if you want to understand an enemy's tactics and predict their actions. And then perception is for searching the area. Acrobatics, if you want to jump or like move through enemy spaces or ally spaces. Yeah, and stealth. I mean, you know stealth.
I did 1 in strength, 2 in occult, 1 in medicine.
Okay, good man.
A little more diversity tonight with skills. Then does that change any of the stuff down here?
Your evasion saving throw should change because your technique changed.
So it'd be 16.
It goes down 1.
Oh, 14.
Yep. The damage you add to like your ranged weapons will change. And the very last thing, James, you get to pick a talent. So they're like feats in this system, basically. I will show you the list of feats of talents.
So where does the damage change on here?
Oh, no, down below, like your weapons. So they should say like 2d6 plus one. It should be 2d6 plus two or whatever now.
Shotgun says 2d6 to 3d6.
Okay, so don't even worry about it then, I guess. It's just whatever that damage thing says. If he didn't write plus one, you don't have to write it. It's just there if you need to remember it, you know. There's a list of talents you get to pick now. Look through any of these that you want. You already have toughness, but you can take anything else.
Cool. I'm able to get the ones I had previously back.
Oh, these are not perks. These are like feats for your character. Okay. They're permanent. Perks are just temporary buffs you can buy. Dempsey, you're the one guy not doing anything right now. Sorry.
That's okay.
Others are all leveling up. So you have a fuckload of rifle ammo.
Yeah.
And no shotgun ammo.
Three.
You could drop the double barrel. Since it's so ammo,
intensive.
Yeah. I mean, it's so strong, you know. And pick
well,
up a rifle.
Well, I mean, the rifle's not bad, right? It was like 2d6.
2d6 with a long range. Mm-hmm. It had the scoped feature, so you could steady your shot and gain extra damage.
Mm-hmm. Can I do anti-up?
Anti-up? You want anti-up? Absolutely. Okay, guys. James just took anti-up as his new talent. He gets auto heal at the start of combat. 3d6 health as soon as initiative drops.
Ooh.
And he gets 6 resource points for free. So he gets fury.
Oh, wow.
It's just, it doesn't do anything for you after initiative starts. Yeah. But...
but that's what he needs. If he starts with fury, then.
And health.
Yeah.
Okay, so wait. What if he's at full health when combat starts?
I don't know.
Then he doesn't get rifle. That.
There's you no overheal aspect? Box, though,
well, no. How much you get? Unless he has the mechanic
if
talent.
If we get a random encounter on the way, you get it the mystery box.
Get the mystery box. And just use overkill.
Six.
I'm kind of down for the
you get six
box,
fury so at the beginning of battle, and you get 3d6 health. You want to go hit the box?
I know.
If you don't get a rifle, though, all that ammo is going to go to waste.
I know.
I mean, 6 months will be plenty.
I don't know why I have so much. I don't know. Like, I don't know who bought all this rifle ammo, but there's a lot of it.
Oh, we found a resupply closet. Oh. And at the time, he still had your rifle. Mm-hmm. But after we found the resupply closet, he hit the box.
Mm-hmm. That's fair.
We never said long-term planning was our strength. So, guys, Odie, what did you take for your new feat?
I'm debating between overkill and
Sixth sense
and like harden.
There was one other thing I forgot to mention earlier. Odie, your character was at full health when you were healing earlier, right?
Uh-huh.
What was the last 2 dice of healing that you rolled? You rolled 16 total. Do you remember how that split at all?
It was 5 and 6 and 4 and 6. No. It was 5. There was a 4 in there, I know. 4, 6.
We'll say 8.
1.
We'll just average it to 8.
Yeah. We'll average it. Because you have the mechanic talent, if you heal someone who is already full health, you can overheal them.
Oh.
But only
once.
Until the end of
the
next battle. Oh, were you full health?
Oh, but no, you didn't heal me. You healed.
Well, it was the ultimate. It healed everybody.
Talking about the ultimate at the end of the battle.
Oh.
Did that get you above full health?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, both of you get 4 overheal. It's not an increase to... that is an increase to max and current until
next battle.
The end of your next battle.
I'm going to just get overkill for hee hee ha-has.
All right.
Overkill. So you're taking a second primary weapon slot.
Yeah.
Instead of your... secondary.
We're already on our way to the box. We're just hoping for a random encounter.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. You assholes. All right, well, outbreak check reset. So you guys have to travel through 2 areas to get back to the mystery box.
Okay.
No encounter
Damn.
In the first one. No
Boo.
Encounter in the second
Boo.
One. We get back to generator 2. We get back to generator 2 without...
Isn't generator 2 the third area that we enter?
No. And there's no robot patrol, but that's okay. Guys, we're going to hit the box and have some more fun when we come back from our 5-minute break. In the meantime, please make sure you stick around. I appreciate all of you so much. I hope you're having a great time. This has been D20 House. See you in a few.
Hey, I'm Kai Gian, and you just watched D20 House. Like, comment, and subscribe.